Good afternoon, everybody. Gonna do a bonus stream today, because I kind of feel like playing some Minecraft. Now, I'll still be recording my XCOM later, but I think I'm gonna want to show you guys a server that I spent quite a bit of Minecraft time on. It's a hardcore PvP server called Survival Hardcore Factions. So, looking forward to seeing what I can do. This is not a new map for Hardcore Factions. This is the Shotbow Lobby with the various Shotbow game modes. I am going to head into the HCFactions portal. And I died the last time I tried this. It was more of a suicide than anything else. But here we are at this map's spawn. One of the interesting things about this game is PvP mode is pretty much turned on all the time. You do have a little bit of free time where monsters can kill you but other players cannot. But in that time you have to get yourself food, get yourself established, hide, and maybe create a base. Let's see what I have in terms of coins. I have 100 coins. I actually haven't looked around this version of HCFactions spawn. The map set resets about every few, I want to say every 6 to 8 weeks. Let's see. I see. Let's get a noob kit. I don't know what the noob kit gets you. Ah, it's a fishing rod, a tree, and some bone meal. Oh, and it didn't even cost me my coins. Well, that's something. So I'll make it a little bit easier to survive, I think, if I can find some fish before we go out into the world. There's also a cannon which will shoot me randomly into a spot somewhere in the world after we've got some of our initial food supply. Alright. Just grab a few fish and then spawn cannon out of here. I always have to worry when I'm fishing that the server will be a little bit lagged and I'll miss my fish. The bedrock there shows the borders of spawn. Once you're past there, you can be killed, or if you tag somebody by hitting them when they're outside of spawn, you can also be attacked in spawn. So we're going to spend our first night or so here, hoping that mobs don't come into spawn, because they can still kill you here, but other players cannot, and then we're going to cannon out in the morning. 8 or 9 fish should get me going. I've played in many of the previous maps. Usually I lone wolf, and I actually wrote the guide to lone wolfing on Reddit. So there's that. Put that on my gaming resume. The Redditors know me, who play on this server, as the old guy, because this community, like many Minecraft communities, has most of the players in their teens and early 20s, and as I'm rapidly approaching 40, I'm a little bit older than the typical Hardcore Factions player, and I'm also not as good at PvP as your average HC Factions individual. I guess it begs the question, why do you play on a Hardcore Factions server at all? And I suppose that's a pretty good question. I think it's the same reason why I played on nasty hardcore PvP servers in World of Warcraft, despite the fact in WoW I was a total Care Bear. I relish the challenge of surviving in the worst environments possible without actually risking life, my actual life and limb. I'm sort of like a geeky Bear Grylls in that sense, I guess. The tip there talks about one of the hardcore aspects of the server, which is the deathban. What they mean by a scaling deathban, and it used to be always 3 days, regardless of how long you've been playing or whatever. Now, the deathban scales to how long you've been playing. So, my last death was, I don't know, I played for 20 minutes before screwing around and jumping in a lava pit. So, I was offline for 20 minutes. But if you've had 5 hours of active time, you will be banned for 5 more hours, and then you can hop back in. Your inventory will still be random. You'll be the naked noob capable of grabbing a kit like I just spawned in here. This initial gearing up phase, I guess, isn't the most exciting thing. But, unfortunately, the excitement for me typically comes in getting killed by somebody in full diamond armor when I'm not even armored up. My strategies have been to hide in my one chunk base, dig deep, and hope that no one knows where I am. I have, in the past, joined a couple of different factions. However, with all Minecraft games, I tend to be, I play in bursts, and that's not the greatest quality for a faction member to have. People expect you to log on, defend the base, do PvP, make potions, all that good stuff. And I can do it, it's just my attention span with this game isn't as long as it is for some other types, like the RPGs and the strategy games you usually see on the channel. Plus, I think once you get down to it, beyond the challenge of survival, one of the points of HC factions is PvP. And I participate in the end of the world, but I'm not much of a griefer. I don't get my excitement out of playing Minecraft by ruining somebody else's day. That said, if someone's being a jerk, I'm happy to kill them with a diamond sword. But I would be about the last person you would find to kill someone who's just playing the server for their first day in no armor just to ratchet up my PvP kill count. So I'm definitely not the typical player on this server, but I do enjoy it. We've got somebody running around planting a tree right outside of spawn. And using his noob kit to... I don't know if that tree is just there to lure somebody out of spawn or what that deal is. I've got 10 fish, so as soon as the sun comes up, I'm pretty much out of here. You can get extra coins. Well, let's get into what coins are used for the people who aren't familiar with HC factions. Coins are gained by coming back to spawn here and selling the ores that you mine. There are also King of the Hill events. Interesting. Someone's just throwing his noob kit off there. Maybe a little exploit there. So you can see that you can sell a stack of diamonds for 1,600 coins. And what coins can be used for is to purchase some of the other things here in spawn. I'm actually not sure. Let's see, you can buy a crowbar which can move monster spawners for 15,000 coins, looks like. You can buy nether wart for 1,500, piece of an end Ender Frame to go to the end to get yourself some Ender Pearls, Slime Ball, or a bit of fire for some of the advanced crafting. You also use your coins to purchase land. When you are on your land, unless you are below power, and you lose your power by getting killed, your stuff can't be griefed. Okay, there's the public end portal. We're not going in there. We will be going to the spawn cannon, though. Our priority is going to be to grab some wood. Maybe a clear path to the surface so I'll have some water for buckets. But otherwise, just hide. And then eventually, I will be able to claim my little chunk of land where other people can't access my doors, break my blocks, come in and stab me, or at least that's the idea. And dig out my little base. And when I believe it's safe, usually at times a low server population, I can run any ores I mine back to spawn here and sell them and basically play survival Minecraft as normal. Usually the sound of thunder indicates someone has died, though there are plugins that give... that makes storms as well. Now, we've also got a portal here to the extreme grass growing arena, a place where you can set up on a board a sign and bet on the last place that grass will expand to. Alright, let's randomly SC launch and boom. Normally I would play with a few mods, map mods and such, but as I do know some of the people on this server actually use Twitch, let's get some seeds, I am not anxious to give out my position. So I will probably not be hitting F3 particularly often, because I don't want folks to know exactly where I've established my base. Especially if they check the stream later. One of the first rules of HCFactions is trust no one. And that's usually not been good enough for me to make sure that I can stay alive, but it's still any advice that I could give to others to say, well, this is the best way to have a chance of staying alive. I am now in the... I think I'm still in the wilderness area. No, I'm probably in the war zone still. And if I think I'm going to have a hard time finding wood, because it looks like a lot of the trees in this area have already been destroyed, I might have to use my bone meal to plant a tree. You know what, let's just do that now. Plant a sapling here, throw some bone meal onto it. I'm not sure how many times I have to hit it with bone meal to get it to... Well, I just used all my bone meal. That didn't work at all. I think I just wasted my bone meal in my impatience. That's alright. It has been a little bit since I've played on this map. Actually, a little bit since I've played any Minecraft at all, aside from the couple of Lone Wolf streams I've done on some other servers. My streaming frames per second appear to be a little... just a sight of horrid. So we're just looking for some wood before we starve to death. Okay, we have left the war zone and we are now in the wilderness. I see a sheep. We can't eat sheep. I can eat uncooked fish, but I'd prefer to be below ground with cooked fish before I lose too many of my little drumstickies. Alright. All we got is sheep, grass, and snow. And one random oak sapling that we no longer have bone meal to grow. What is this? I see a tasty cow. Come here, cow. I would like to eat you. We got some beef, but no leather. For all I know, that was the last cow in these parts. Now, one nice thing, since I'm not actually getting my position via F3 for reasons I described earlier, is that I know because I've gone from the war zone into the wilderness that I'm headed away from spawn. I'm not just walking back into some place that's more dangerous. So I've got that going for me, which is nice. Okay, I see some leaves, but I'm guessing that most of the wood from that tree has already been taken. I'm not inclined to build up. Looks like all of it's been taken. One of the disadvantages to hopping in mid-map is a lot of the easy-to-grab resources have been grabbed. Just want some basic tools. One of the reasons I am not running is because it would make my hunger bar deplete just a little faster, and that's something that I cannot have. I do have some tasty fish, but I would prefer to save those tasty fish for the moment. Someone from the faction Straw Bats on. I believe I have been in a faction before with Epic Mersek. Okay, well, there's some wood here, so let's at least build up and grab some of that wood since we wasted our bone meal. In a particularly noobish moment of impatience. But I can at least get rolling here. Just beating this tree up. I'm gonna take every last little bit of wood I can reach before it gets dark. Come here. And the more experienced players on the server, despite the fact I've been playing since, like, map 4, I know they're, if they see this video, they'll probably be laughing at me, because there are some people who can be on the server for 10, 15 minutes, and they'd already have diamonds and be working on their first enchanting station. Me, I'm just looking for trees. I just don't move as fast as the kids. Which is why I am frequently a free source of kills and diamonds and chunks of iron and fish for those who love to murder. going to see another tree, so I'm just going to grab as much of this as I can. Pretty big tree. Come on. I'm going to get a little bit more wood than I ordinarily would, because there's no guarantee I'm actually going to find any charcoal in the time frame I'm going to want it. Alright, that should be enough. Let's find a spot to dig down. We got some sand here. Like to find... Oh, heck. And maybe this is not the best place to establish a base. Let's see if this is an active base or not. Yeah, this totally looks like an active base. Yeah. In addition to having neighbors who might wish to kill me, the other downside to establishing where someone else already has is that most of the tunnels at convenient levels will already have been mined out of all significant ore. Not exactly what I like out of my Minecraft experience. Although, being terrified and not finding any ore does have its advantages. We're not going to go over to Mr. Creeper. I do see some coal there. So let's, make some planks. Table. Equip a couple of sticks. Use my sticks to make a pickaxe. Okay, where was that? Where was that coal? And we'll hope we're not too close to Mr. Creeper, because I want to go below ground pretty much now. If textures look weird at first, it's because the server does use a plugin that limits the effectiveness of X-ray. Makes fake ores appear. I think the side of this hill is going to be the start of our little base. Let me quick make a couple of torches here. Okay. And we'll box ourselves in. I want to grab all of this coal so I won't have any problems. Yeah, I see that redstone and fake diamonds, all that stuff just disappeared. And then we'll grab enough to cook up our tasty, tasty fish. And then we'll start mining down. I'm not sure where I'm going to want to establish. But in this area doesn't sound like too bad an idea. And never dig straight down. Alright. So slap down our... I'm not sure. I could check the PvP time left, but I don't see any point. I don't have quite enough to make a stove, or furnace rather, and another pickaxe. So I'll just grab some more cobble. sticks. Get ourselves that. And... let's use our wooden pickaxe as fuel. Start cooking up fish. While we wait for dinner to cook, you'll see I'm crouching. One of the reasons I do that is because if you crouch, your name is not visible, at least to those who are not cheating, so long as there is a block in between you and the person who's looking for you. Otherwise, someone can kind of see your nameplate hovering. Unfortunately, I don't have a mod called Toggle Sneak installed at the moment, which allows you to just constantly be in crouch mode, even if you're looking at furnaces or crafting blocks. Assuming that the frames per second are actually somewhat relevant, I'll probably throw this up on YouTube with the other things I stream. Let's eat some fish. We've got some seeds. I feel kind of silly having wasted all that bone meal on a tree it turns out I did not grow and didn't even need. Now we should be able to cook our one steak and the rest of this fish without wasting any more coal. I feel pretty safe in turning the rest of my wood into planks. Now we'll leave five behind just in case. Yeah, we'll reclaim this here. Grab our stake and start moving down. Now, normally, if I care about reaching the surface quickly, I will just make some stairs before I tunnel down. But I don't care so much about that this time, so I'm just gonna tunnel down. Ooh, iron. Well, that was quick. Maybe a good thing I didn't leave the surface. I got enough for a bucket. Dare I live the dream and attempt to get enough for a bucket and a pickaxe? It seems like when you look at the things people are most often killed by, players are number one, but starvation is a big concern on the server as well. I have no idea why my frames per second are looking so low on the laptop I use for chat. I just did a fresh reboot. So, I don't think it's on my end. It might just be that the server is not vanilla enough for me to run everything and stream at the same time with my aging PC. It's going to affect whether the stream makes it up onto YouTube or not. Alright, well, we've got a few things here. We'll move down and decide what to do with them later. I'm not rushing back up to the surface with a bucket to get water just yet. I can survive down here just on my on my fish. It's tricky because normally I'd be checking my depths, but on the off chance that I do end up uploading this video and linking it to Reddit, I'd like to improve my chances of survival just a little. Although many of the folks who know me typically don't kill me, there are a lot of people who don't know me on the server, and some people who don't care who you are, they're just going to murder you. I mean, it is kind of the point of a PvP server, so I don't hold any ill will towards those individuals. And I broke my torch. That was silly. Now, we're not gonna have a problem finding charcoal. Or obfuscator is really being a tease, though I wouldn't have expected to find diamonds or redstone at this level. But it's obfuscating every single block. I might be lagging a little bit, which would also explain what I'm seeing on the laptop screen for the stream. Alright, well, I'm going to stop picking up my torches now that I've got all that charcoal. Worst case scenario, someone can use torches to follow me down here and steal all my nothing. My tasty fish and my six iron. I suppose I would travel less if I just kind of did a 1x2 cha-cha. Something a little bit like this. Since I don't intend on taking those stairs back up anyway, this is fine. I feel like I'm in the Well of Souls. Let's drop that right there and make a new one. While we're here, let's make a couple spares. We don't need a button. I got enough iron to make a pickaxe, I guess. I was joking about living the dream and making both a minute ago, but we'll start with stone at the moment. Look at all that. Oh. Of course, I suppose I'll know that I'm at the right depth if I hit somebody else's tunnels. That'll also mean that I'm highly less likely to actually find anything. There's all sorts of other survival tips I could give, like checking the overworld map to make sure you're not near any hostile factions and all that. You know, stuff that I'd normally do, but I'm not bothering this time. I am not entirely certain that I'm going to get anything out of this particular run other than, like, basic tools and a one-way trip back to spawn. But you never know. This could be the launch of the next successful series here on the channel as I make my solo base and have all these cool diamonds and then someone murders me. And then the rage. So much rage. That's gonna be my last torch. Work work our way down, down, down. I can hear lava, so we're probably pretty close to being able to tunnel to the side. I'm guessing depth at this point, since my normal means of checking it through a mini-map mod or hitting F3 are things I've decided for this stream I'm not going to do. Make things a little bit more hardcore. Rawr. And I'm guessing, since we're seeing some redstone, that this is not a terrible place to start digging. Start out, like, with a little branch mine. And we'll know for sure that I'm mining in the right place if we actually see some diamond ore. Wow, ore obfuscator is being so aggressive. Every single block is turning into something else. I suppose I should be following best practices. You know, you can actually sell this stuff for money. So I suppose before too much longer I should be getting myself an iron pickaxe just for the redstone. While I'm down here, yeah, I got 4 more iron ore. Let's go ahead and do that. Make a quick pickaxe. And a busket. We'll cook up the new iron. We'll grab here. I might actually make some iron armor. Give myself some insulation against the embarrassing deaths, like being killed by skeletons or zombies when you're just trying to get potatoes and XP. I've died so many times from underestimating monsters on this server. I always feel like a noob idiot when I do it. Be nice to find a cave or something down here. It's gonna take too cold to cook all that. I've almost got enough iron that I'm comfortable just making the rest of my pickaxes out of it. After playing on certain other servers where iron is so much more rare and is used as currency, just being able to make tools out of iron seems like a life of unparalleled luxury. Ball, do you have extra mushrooms? There's DJ. DJ Maddox was actually the admin that talked me into adding this to my live stream. Hey DJ, guess what? I'm streaming. Go to Twitch. We'll see if we can't get some of the people who are on up in the channel. Which actually means I'll have to open up the laptop again and actually maybe look at chat. He likes my mustache. I assume he's talking to me. I'm Nessie. Already got folks trying to peep my cords. Not that I'm doing anything exciting right now. I should probably, instead of wasting torches, just check out the adjust my brightness so I don't actually have to see down here, but I don't know. Alright, I got enough iron, enough with this stupidity. Stone pickaxes are so slow. If you are on the chat and also in game, let me know if it's streaming like super slow. Because I'm not gonna post this to YouTube and the Reddit if the subreddit if this is just slide showing by. I just felt like live streaming something different than XCOM for a little bit. I will be doing the XCOM live stream later on today, though, since I do have a day off from my day job. Holy ore obfuscator, Batman. I don't dare hit F3 to get my depth right now. Now that I've let people who are on the server know that I'm streaming. I have one viewer. Someone patiently watching. Waiting. Yeah, we've got some of our basic tools here. I'd love to find diamonds. The FD mod, like for found diamonds, will announce to the whole server that I've just found one. I'm not even sure I'm quite deep enough to do that. But there's lava all around. I'd say that there's a pretty good shot that we'll find some diamonds here, and that's probably where I'd like to leave off for the afternoon. Oh boy. That's always exciting. Before I get my first bucket together, I tunnel into some lava. I guess we'll make another lava. Okay. Fine. Stop and make another pickaxe before too much longer. And I don't know, I used to get so mad when I was playing on the server and someone would just tunnel right to me and kill me, and I just came to the point where it's like, cheater's gonna cheat. Some people are going to use X-ray no matter how much I rage, and in fact, that sort of person would probably be happy to know that they made me rage. Whatever. If it bothers me too much, I'll just stop playing the server for a couple weeks or months. It's fun, but at the end of the day, and this is a game, and if I'm not having fun playing that game, I don't really see a point. So, I'm an independent, strong independent Steve who don't need no man. And we're creeping up on 5 o'clock here. I think that even if I don't find some diamonds, I'm gonna have to call it before this entire video is just me randomly mining and basically attempting to survive. I'll be able to show off one of the other features of this server before I call it, and that is the safe logout. Get some more iron here. I'm gonna have to unstealth briefly to make a few more torches. And we'll do that as well. And we'll throw our coal on the ground, because that's what we do. It's gangster or something. Go back to sneaking manually. Because my PvP time might already be up. I haven't really been paying attention to how long I've been recording. So yeah, we're all about best practices here on this stream. No important mods, no checking your coordinates to make sure you're not going to spawn, no appropriately using your bone meal to get something useful. I may just dig down here and keep going at the new depth. I didn't know what the old depth was. You may notice in the game chat, oh, I'm certainly deep enough. That's what he said. That people are talking about somebody being raidable or not raidable. I was talking about how when you are on your faction land, people can't break your blocks, and people can't enter your chests or use your doors or use your switches, all that fun stuff. Basically, you have something in this game called power. And the way you get power is to win it through events, kill other people who have it, and you start with a little bit. How you lose power is to be killed. You slowly regenerate power. Oh, this stuff can't possibly be real. Okay, or obfuscator. No, that was just a lag spike. Or obfuscator just trolled me hard. Come on. You're not really nether quartz. You're not really wood. Ah, there we go. Oh, we got his lag spikes. Yeah, server's getting a little laggy. I think I'm going to call it in a minute or so here. But if you lose enough power, you become raidable. And in that time, your chests can be opened or smashed, your doors can be opened, or smashed, I suppose. And people can just take your stuff, burn, and pillage as they like. It's generally considered good form to not grief too much against someone who just gave you a good fight. If someone's being a jerk, pretty much do as you like. But it's generally considered good manners to take what's valuable and not destroy somebody's work too much. I know that last map there was a big hullabaloo. Yeah, I said it. I'm old. About factions who destroyed bases that someone had obviously worked a very, very long time on making functional and pretty. It was generally considered poor form. There was a bit of arguments about what is considered poor form on a hardcore server. And I suppose that's a discussion that's worth having. I just know that most of the arguments that end in, but doing this is hardcore, kind of, if they're followed to their logical conclusion, say that it's cool, you can be hardcore on a server alone, because the other people who have that same attitude, they hide in their base unless they've got easy kills, and all of the people who would provide you easy kills, myself included, will get frustrated and will leave. We'll play other places, and you'll be happy because you kick the noobs off the server, and GG and all that. But then you realize that you're alone on the server. So, yeah, good job there. Making a good job there. Let's not proselytize and just die to lava. Alright. I think it is time for a safe logout. And once I have gotten through my 30 seconds of standing here vulnerable, I will cut to back to the stream. Let's not move. That'll screw it up. And we'll shut it down for the afternoon. And I'll probably go back online in a few moments to do the XCOM stream. It looks like I'm wrapping up just as we're getting folks in the channel. So here I am back in the Shot Bow lobby. And that was Hardcore Factions, so I appreciate everybody who popped up here at the end to tune in. It's a good time as always. I'll be streaming a little bit more Hardcore Factions, I think. Follow me on Twitch if you like. Assuming that this video wasn't a total slideshow, I will be popping it up onto YouTube and then linking it in the subreddit. So, looks like DocStout is back with a vengeance on the HC Factions server. And not that there's a whole lot of vengeance. I suppose I need to avenge myself from all the people who've killed me. So yeah, leave me some comments over on Twitch, and thanks for tuning in, everybody. And we'll talk to everybody later.